Hello, welcome to Vocabulary Live from BBC Learning English. I'm Phil, here as well, almost always in my house here in London. Thank you for joining us. I'm so happy that you're here. Today, talk about happy, we're talking about feelings, and we're going to look at some vocabulary to talk about feelings. So if you'd just like to say hi in the comments and say where you're watching from, and also just a little note, if you do miss anything, don't worry, because we're posting the whole thing up on our Facebook and YouTube feeds as soon as we've finished. So you'll be able to watch it all again if you want to. In fact, maybe you're doing that now. And if you are watching the replay, hello, please join in just as much as if you're watching it live. It is live, of course. So do please join in with the comments. I'm going to be asking you quite a lot of questions, and you'll get the most from this lesson if you put your answers into the comments, and I'll share as many as I can with you as we go through. I see loads of people saying hello already, like Melinda in Indonesia, hello. Hello to Anna in Vietnam. Hello to John in Cameroon, and Guy in France. Hello to all of you. As you're joining in, we're going to start by just going through a few words. Some of them may be new, some of them you might know already. Over here, I want you to have a look at some of these words, which are all feelings words, they're all adjectives, and I want you to think whether they're positive or negative. As we do that, I'll say hi to a few more people, but just have a look. Are these words fulfilled, tetchy, lonely, content, satisfied and anxious? Are they negative or positive words? And just put in the comments, put the word and the number, whether you think it's negative or positive. Let's have a look. Let's see who else we've got. Christos from Greece, hello. Hello to Tola from Cambodia. Ala from Poland, hello, welcome. Hello to Sunny from India. Hello to all of you, wherever you're watching. Okay. Let's have a look at some of these words then. Are these words negative or positive? All these words to do with feelings. So the first one we've got here is fulfilled. Fulfilled. Do you think that's positive? Do you think it's positive, which is number two, or negative, number one? What do you think? Just put it into the comments. Let's have a look and we'll see what people say. Okay, let's have a look. Fulfilled. Okay, fulfilled. It's definitely positive. Fulfilled is a positive word. If you are fulfilled, it means you're getting everything you want from life. You're feeling very happy and you've got everything you need. You're feeling fulfilled. Perhaps you're feeling that you're making a difference, that you're doing something good. So yes, fulfilled is definitely positive. And we see some people have said that already. Johanna has said that it's positive. Joha has also said that it's positive. Olga is saying that it's positive. Great. Okay, let's have a look. You may not know this word. Don't worry if you don't, because you will very soon. Tetchy. Does anyone know whether tetchy is negative or positive? And also what it means, perhaps. Maybe you don't know it. That's all right. Don't worry if you don't. You will in a second. What do you think? Is tetchy negative or positive? If you have just joined us, this is Vocabulary Live from BBC Learning English. And I'm Phil. And we're looking at words that we can use to talk about feelings. Let's see. I see an answer already. Eileen is saying that tetchy is negative. Yevgeny saying tetchy is to be easily upset. Let's have a look. Yes, tetchy, it's negative. And as Yevgeny said, tetchy means to be easily upset. If you're very irritable, you're in a bad mood, maybe you feel a bit tetchy and you get angry with people very easily, you might be tetchy. It's an adjective. Okay. Right. Lonely. I think you probably know this word. Lonely. Is that positive or negative? What do you think? Don't get it confused with alone. Lonely, positive or negative? What do you think? I think lots of people get this right. Olga has said that lonely is negative, as of Stanislav. And actually, I suspect you probably all knew that one. Lonely is a negative word. It's different to alone. If we use alone, that's not necessarily negative. That's neutral. But if you feel lonely on your own, it's definitely negative. Okay, the next one, content. Remember, the stress is on the tent. Content. What does content mean, and is it negative or positive? What do you think? Let's have a look in the comments. See a few coming in. For content, Jaime is saying that content is positive. Soraya is also saying that content is positive. Fatia is saying positive. Let's see. Content. Yeah, if you're content, you're happy. You're happy with everything you've got. You're feeling content, then you're feeling happy. So it's definitely a positive thing. Okay, we've got two more here. Satisfied and anxious. Satisfied and anxious. What do you think? Which is number one? Which is number two? Probably work this out, but let's see. I can see some answers coming in already. Talby, satisfied is positive. Nang Lin is also saying satisfied. I can't say it. Satisfied is positive. Mukul saying all satisfied is it? Let's have a look. Sure. Satisfied is definitely positive. If you're satisfied, it's kind of similar to fulfilled. You're very happy with what you've got. All your needs are being met. You're satisfied. It's obviously a positive feeling. And we've got another one here. Anxious. Again, perhaps you know anxious. Anxious is, of course, negative. If you're anxious, then you're worried about things. Okay, great. So all these were words to talk about feelings, but we're actually going to look at three in a bit more depth, three expressions that we can use to talk about our feelings. I want to start again, as always, with a question. So have a look at these sentences I'm going to put on the screen now. Have a look at these sentences. I've taken some words out of these sentences, and I'm sure you can work out what I'm going to ask you to do, is I want you to look and see where you would put those words in those sentences. Where do you think they should go? You can just use the numbers if you want, 1, 2, and 3, and then the words that go there. We've got number one, it's important to look after your something. Friends and health can be the something to happiness. What do you think goes in number two? And number three, loneliness can be, it's hard to cope with. What do you think goes into these gaps? Okay, do put it into the comments. I'm just waiting to see your answer. Please put your answer into the comments. What do you think the answer is? Okay, for each of these. And these are the expressions we're going to look at in more depth today. Oh, I can see loads of answers coming in already. So if you haven't got your answer in, try and get it in now into the comments. Also, if you know anyone who might want to join this lesson, do please share it with them. You can all share and invite other people to come in. Let's have a look. Okay, so number one, it's important to look after your... Ted is saying it's well-being. William's also saying well-being. Actually, I quite like this one. Stanislav saying it's important to look after your keys. It is important to look after your keys. But actually, it's going to come somewhere else, that one. Nadi is saying well-being. Let's see who else has said anything. We've got lots of comments. Okay, let's have a look at the answer to this one. Number one, it's important to look after your well-being. Excellent. And we'll look a little bit more at what that means in a minute. It's important to look after your well-being. It is also important to look after your keys, so I suppose you could fit that in as well. But it's important to look after your well-being. Okay, and we'll have a little look in a minute as to what that actually means. Okay, so we've got two and three. We've got keys and overwhelming. What do you think should go into gap number two? Let's have a look. And I've seen lots of comments coming in. Norma says that keys is actually number two. Nadi agrees. Lujain thinks that it's keys. Well, that's Nadi again. Zina says it's keys. Olga also says it's keys. Okay, let's have a look. Yeah. Friends and health can be the keys to happiness. Maybe think about what that means. We're going to look in a minute, but what does that mean? Friends and health can be the keys to happiness. What do you think that means? Okay. And so the last one, number three, I'm going to have a look at the answers, but you can probably work out what it is for number three. Like Isaiah says that it's overwhelming. Juan has also put overwhelming. And of course, It's actually the only answer we've got left. So it is overwhelming. Loneliness can be overwhelming. It's hard to cope with. Think about what these words in red mean, because we're going to have a look at them now. I'm going to ask some questions. So let's start by going to well-being. Okay, we've got this phrase, this example. It's important to look after your well-being. So what is well-being? Well, definition, someone's state of health or happiness. So it's not just your health, although your health is part of your well-being, but it's a bit more in general. It's also about how you feel, your happiness. Might also be about, you talk about your financial well-being. You can talk about if your situation with money is good, then maybe that helps you feel better. It's all part of your well-being. There's lots of things together. So if we look at some examples, we say that talking about your feelings can improve your well-being. Talking about your feelings can improve your well-being. So that might be about, that might help how you feel. And it's part of it. It's not just your physical health. It's kind of everything together. There's a few questions. Yeah, I heard you saying well-being means your health. It often does, and it can include your health, but it's a bit more general. It's not just your physical health. It's also about how you feel and your situation in which you are. So it includes happiness, it includes mental health, physical health, all of these things together. It's kind of a mix of different things. Let's have a look at another example. This may be true in your country, it may not be, but employers have a responsibility towards their employees' well-being. And that might be looking at their feelings. It might be looking at mental health. It might be looking at physical health. It might be looking at the financial side of things as well. But well-being is quite general. Okay, I've got a question coming up. Let's have a look. Let's test you here. So well-being, is it 1, 2, or 3? Is well-being something a doctor can measure? Is it a level of physical health? Was it a combination of factors? What do you think it is? 1, 2, or 3? And put your answers in the comments. We'll see what people are saying. Okay. If you are just joining us, this is Vocabulary Live from BBC Learning English. And I'm Phil. And don't worry if you've missed any of it, because it's all going up on our Facebook and our YouTube channels as soon as we finished. So you'll be able to watch it again. If you are watching the replay, hello. Thank you for joining. And remember, you can join in with the questions just as much as everyone else. Do join in, do try and answer the questions. It'll help you. If you think about these words, it'll help you remember them better, I think. Okay, we've got lots of answers coming in here. So Abu Becker is saying it's number 3. Bill is saying it's number 2. Misato is saying it's number 3. Isil saying it's number 2. Ol saying is saying number 2. A few different answers, lots of number 2s and lots of number 3s. Well, sorry. Brenda is saying number 3. Tyre is saying number 3. Zena saying number 2. Nadia saying number 3. Bill is saying number 3. Okay, we've got a few different answers. Let's have a look. Most people are saying 2 or 3. Okay, for me, well-being, it's a combination of factors. So it will include your level of physical health. Well-being can include your physical health. But it's a bit more general than that. It's also talking about our feelings, talking about our mental health, and talking about the state that we're in. So it's more than just your physical health, although physical health is a very important part of it. So I would say the correct answer is number 3, okay? But number 2 is an important part of it. But when we talk about well-being, we talk about a little bit more than just health. We're talking about lots of things together. Okay. Well, I want to ask you actually some questions now, and I want to see if you can share with us what things do you think are important for your well-being? What things do you think are important for your well-being? Oh, look, I want to share some of the ideas that you've got. So have a think for you what things are important for well-being. If you have just joined us, this is Vocabulary Live from BBC Learning English. And we're talking about feelings and words we can use to talk about feelings. An important one is actually well-being, to talk about how you feel. It comes up a lot. So we've got a few things here. Natasha says that wealth is important for well-being. Rosie says that friends are important for well-being. I think that's a common one. Ada saying that family is important. Cesar is saying health and family. Sleep might be important for your well-being. Getting good sleep. Yes. I just want to hear Mabel saying feeling in peace. Yes. Similar to lots of people. Robert is saying happy family. A happy family is good for your well-being. Yes. Feeling valued, says Tina. That's a really nice one. Feeling valued. So feeling that people feel what you're doing is important. Evgeny saying your friends are the keys to your well-being. Yes. Soldi Camila saying health, happiness, and love. Apologies if I pronounce anyone's name wrong. I'm really sorry. Hajiba says family, money, and traveling are important for well-being. It's probably different for different people as well. Isil saying health, psychology, mood, all of those things. Yoga, active in Tarsian, saying that yoga is important for well-being. Zena, being with people who always make you smile can improve your well-being. I think that's a really nice example there. Let's have a look through. Wealth and health, says Sweetie. Yes, a lot of people saying these ones. I think lots of people would agree with that. Self-confidence. Yes, that's a good one. That's an important one from NASA there. Self-confidence can help your well-being. Excellent. Okay, brilliant. Right, let's move on. And there was a hint in some of the comments there. Let's look at the next word that we had here, or the next expression we bring up on the screen. We have this example, and I think it came up in one of the a couple of the comments there. Friends and health can be the keys to happiness. The keys to happiness. Now, what do we mean by the keys to something? Okay, it could be the keys to happiness. It could be the keys to something else as well. Okay. It's a really vague definition, this, but the keys to something are something that makes something else happen. So having good friends, having good health, that can be something that makes happiness happen. It can be the key to happiness. It can lead to happiness. So this expression keys, obviously, usually you use them to open the door, but it's this image that we're opening up happiness with these things. It makes something happen, the key to. So, oh yeah, someone said that. I can see Anna saying the fundamental elements. Yeah, the fundamental elements of could be a way of looking at it. That's a nice way of saying it. Let's have a look at some examples. So for me, the key to happiness is time spent with my family. Okay, so for me, the key to happiness is time spent with my family. And a lot of you were saying that as part of well-being as well in the comments. You may agree with that. The keys to happiness. And we've got an example here of how you can have the key to something else. Teamwork is the key to success. We can have the key to happiness, the key to success. It's something that leads to. So being able to work together in a team might be what leads you to be successful. So you could say that teamwork is the key to success. You may agree, you may disagree. Okay, let's have a look then. I've got another question for you to think about, and we'll come and have a look at your answers in a minute. The keys to happiness are things that are needed to be happy, the benefits of being happy, or the consequences of happiness. What do you think? One, two, or three? Put your answer into the comments and I'll see what people are saying. Okay, thank you so much for joining us. This is Vocabulary Live from BBC Learning English. I'm Phil, and we're looking at words we can use to talk about feelings. So let's have a little through look here at what you think the answers are. Muna is saying it's number two. Yevgeny is saying number one. Yu is saying number one. Bemin saying number one. Let's have a look. Ooh, loads coming. Kalaya is saying it's number one. Happy Life saying number one. Omar is saying number one. Okay, everyone is saying number one, I'm noticing. Which is just as well, really, because that is the right answer. Yeah, the keys to happiness are the things that are needed to be happy. So it's not the result of being happy, but it's what you need to be happy. Those are the keys to happiness. So you may be able to guess what question I'm going to ask you now, but I want to hand it over to you. What are the keys to happiness for you? And these are going to be different for different people, and that's fine. But I'd love you to share, what are the keys to happiness for you? What are your keys to happiness? What do you think they are? Do put them into comments and into the comments, and we'll share. We'll look at some of them and share them. Please tell me, what are the keys to happiness for you? Okay, what do you think? Please put it into the comments. As I said, if you have missed any of this, don't worry. We'll have it all up on our Facebook and YouTube feeds as soon as we finish, so you can watch again. If you are watching again, please do also join in and share your ideas here with everyone who's watching with you. And also remember, you can invite anyone else to come and watch, or you can share this video with anyone. Let's have a look. So R is saying to be free is a key to happiness. Being around positive people, Rosie says, could be the key to happiness. Living in peace could be the keys to happiness. I think Mac is asking me, what are the keys to happiness for you? Well, for me, yeah, having time, family, and not worrying about things. I think for me, those are the keys to happiness. But what about you? Olesia saying, attention to the dearest people. Yeah, a lot of this about family. Nelly, it's travel. Quite a few people have said travel. Yep, travel. That might be linked to the being free that we saw earlier. Travel might be the key to happiness for you. Ravi says learning. Oh, I think that's probably true for me as well, actually. Learning and gaining knowledge, that can be a key to happiness. It makes you feel good, maybe. Guy says a good nap. That's not a bad idea. Yes, a good nap. That can be the key to happiness if you can have a nice sleep. We've talked about family, and for Chitina saying the well-being of my children can be the key to happiness. Yeah, definitely. I can see how that can be true. Books. So books, maybe. Okay, yeah, similar to the one, learning might be a key to happiness, but reading books can be the key to happiness. Satisfaction, whatever that is for you, might be the key to happiness, says Soha. Okay, great. Learning English, maybe that's the key to happiness for you, perhaps. That's a good one. I like that one. Okay. Right, brilliant. So we looked at the keys to happiness. Now, they've all been quite positive. We're going to look at one now that's perhaps a bit less positive. We've got this expression, and a lot of people often think about this. We're not talking about loneliness so much, but this word, overwhelming. Loneliness can be overwhelming. It's hard to cope with. Overwhelming, yes. If something is overwhelming, basically it's too strong to fight against. You can't stop it. If you're overwhelmed, we can use it as a verb as well. Overwhelming is an adjective. Overwhelmed would be a verb. Or overwhelm is a verb. It means that you can't stop something. You can't cope with it, perhaps, or it's too strong. You can't reduce it in any way if something is overwhelming. Let's look at a couple of examples. Someone might say, I've got too much stress from work. I'm finding it overwhelming. Okay, if you're finding something overwhelming, it means you can't, you're finding things very difficult because you can't stop the stress from affecting you. It's overwhelming you. You find it overwhelming. This might be a piece of advice that you might give to someone. Talk to someone if you're feeling overwhelmed. Okay, or maybe get some help if you're feeling overwhelmed. And there's the verb there. If you can't cope with something, if something's too strong for you to deal with. Okay, so overwhelming is this idea that something is too strong to cope with. Let's have a look at a question. Let's see. Test yourself, and then we'll ask you again to share your ideas. But what do you think of this? Overwhelming. An overwhelming feeling is, number one, a difficult feeling that you can tolerate. Number two, a feeling that's too strong to stop. Or number three, a feeling that's not as bad as it seems. What do you think? One, two, or three? If we describe something as overwhelming, is it number one, a difficult feeling that you can tolerate? And if you think it's that one, just put number one in the comments. Number two, a feeling that's too strong to stop. Or number three, a feeling that's not as bad as it seems. What do you think? What do you think the meaning is from what we've just said? Okay, let's have a look and see what people are saying. I'm seeing lots of very similar answers here. Suleiman is saying that it's number two. Irina is saying that it's number two. Bill saying number one. Armin is saying number two. Wiraka is saying number two. Again, apologies if I pronounce your name wrong. Ximena is saying number two, or Ximena is saying number two. Maeda also saying number two. Okay, let's have a look. We've got lots of answers coming in, and most people are saying number two. Okay, let's have a look. Yes, so you might have a feeling that's difficult, but you can tolerate it. If you can tolerate it, it might be hard. It might make you tetchy, I don't know, but it's not overwhelming. Okay, an overwhelming feeling is a feeling that's just too strong to stop, and maybe it stops you doing things because you can't control it. That's the idea of overwhelming. So it's a bit different from number one. It's that idea to be overwhelmed. If something overwhelms something, it means it just stops it being able to cope with it. You can't fight against it because it's overwhelming, an overwhelming force. Okay, let's put this into practice and let's see what you think here. Only share things that you're happy to share, but which feelings can be overwhelming, do you think? Which feelings do you think can be overwhelming sometimes? And again, this may be different for different people. Which feelings do you think are overwhelming? Well, we've got a nice example here, actually, of the meaning just here. The genius saying overwhelmed most commonly means to cause, to be overcome with emotion as an amount or something. Yeah, that's a nice explanation, Tangina. Thank you. Yevgeny saying being overwhelmed by stress is destructive for your well-being. What else? What other feelings can be overwhelming? If you have just joined us, this is BBC Learning English, and this is Vocabulary Live. And we're looking at vocabulary to talk about feelings. So this one that we're looking at the moment is this word overwhelming. And again, you have the verb as well, overwhelm. What do you think it is? And I'm saying being away from family and friends is too difficult. I find it overwhelming. Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people feel like that. It can be, it's very hard to cope with. And maybe it stops you doing something sometimes. Anger. Sometimes people can get overwhelmed by anger and then they might lose control. Thank you, Hafsa. That's a really good example. Any others? Fear of something I've just seen there from Helena. Helena, the fear of something. Fear can be overwhelming. Fear can stop you doing things. It can, you can find it hard to fight against. Sometimes for a good reason, but yeah. Johanna saying that anxiety can be overwhelming. A lot of these negative feelings we've got here. Anna talking about panic, tension, anxiety again, fear, stress. These are all feelings that can be overwhelming. Usually bad emotions, overwhelming. Usually it's bad emotions. We've got here April saying post-traumatic stress. That's a medical condition. Post-traumatic stress after something bad can be overwhelming and perhaps could appear as nightmares. That's a good example of using it. Work can sometimes be overwhelming. If you have too much pressure at work, that can sometimes be overwhelming. Thank you, Ali. That's a really good example. Brilliant. What other things could be? Ooh. Exams. Exams can cause a lot of stress. If you have particularly important exams coming up, the feelings around them can be overwhelming. Thank you, Abdul Bari. That's a good example. Jacqueline's saying depression. Yeah, depression is often being overwhelmed by events. Yes. Sadness, again, sadness can be overwhelming, says Anna. Yes, definitely. A lot of these bad feelings. You can be, Graciela saying, bad news. You can be overwhelmed by bad news. You just can't cope with it. Bad news coming from everywhere, and it can be hard to deal with. It can cause stress and anxiety. Yeah. Rick is saying pressure. Things, yeah, like we talked about work being overwhelming pressure. You may have overwhelming pressure at work and it stops you being able to do what you want to do. Good question here from Daniel. Happiness cannot be overwhelmed. Yeah, you could be overwhelmed by happiness. If there's a happiness, you just can't control it. Then yeah, happiness can be overwhelming. So it can be positive things as well, particularly strong feelings. But yeah, you could have overwhelming happiness. Perhaps we talk about it less. But yeah, that's a really good question, Daniel. Thanks. Um, Ooh, sibling rivalry and academic pressure. Yes, possibly. Pressure in the family, I guess, could be very overwhelming, I'd imagine. The academic pressure. Yeah, if you have to do well in your exams, as we said earlier, that could be an overwhelming feeling. People could get overwhelmed by stress there. Okay. Thank you so much, everyone, for your comments. There's loads of them there. We've just about run out of time for today. So if you've missed anything, if you want to watch it again, it's on YouTube and Facebook as soon as we finish, which will be in about a minute. Do make sure you're subscribed to and following BBC Learning English. And remember, we have a live lesson every Monday. It's either pronunciation or vocabulary. And of course, we also have grammar lessons on Wednesday. And then every other week, we have a quiz on Friday. So there's lots of live lessons that you can join in on BBC Learning English. So please make sure you do. Thank you so much for your company today. It's been great to be here with you. I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.